first comic. She's super awesome. She performs all over San Diego, and she's been kind enough to really just take me under her wing and mentor me in more ways than one. Comedy, spiritually, she's a rad lady. Please give a warm, warm welcome to Miss Lisa Gilbert.
Because I am a 50-year-old mother of 6-year-old triplets. And I'm glad to be here mostly because they're not. So I don't even really need you to laugh. However, tonight somebody had the great idea of bringing them here. So not really sure how to start out, but I'm a 50-year-old mother of 6-year-old triplets, and I got married late. I got married at 44 years old, and I actually waited. I was sitting in a training, and God told me to stop dating. Now, I thought he was talking to the girl next to me, right? Because clearly he wasn't going to take all this off the market. But he was like, no, we're talking to you, And so I was like, all right, fine, but I didn't listen. For 3 more years, I didn't listen. And then finally I got my head together and I'm like, okay, I'm ready to make this commitment and not date and make so many men just so incredibly unhappy. So during that time, I would just show God what I wanted in a husband. Like a Dropbox, you know, like a Jesus Dropbox. So I'd see like a nice pair of legs and I'd be like, those are nice strong legs, just put that in the Dropbox, you know. Some nice hands, about 6'5", put that in the Dropbox. Nice personality, that's good, that smile, you see that, Jesus? We'll just put that right in the Dropbox. And then I met my husband at church, and when I saw him, I knew that that's who God had for me. Except that I don't think he looked at the Dropbox. And the triplets. And first sonogram appointment, my husband wasn't there because we had just come back from a missions trip, and so he was sick. And so I went by myself, and I got there, and the nurse is doing the sonogram, and all of a sudden she gets this look on her face. She's just being in a relationship in your 40s as opposed to your 20s. You know, in your 20s and your man wants to go out with his friends and you're like, don't go. I miss you so much. Boy, you're gone. Text me. In your 40s, it's like, you're calling up his friends. Somebody come better pick this fool up right now.
Thank you.
I did not think this through. It's good though. I'm enjoying being a mom. My kids are amazing, and you know, they teach you so much. Like, my kids are teaching me how to be a liar. That's what's happening. And the day I'm sitting at home, and my kids are like, Mom, what are we going to do today? I'm like, well, this is it. You got an old mom, it's not your fault. They're like, well, can we go to the park today? I said, we cannot go to the park today. The park is broken. Changes, right? Like for the short time before I had kids and I think about my husband, the music in my heart, it was something romantic, like, I've been really trying, baby, trying to hold back these feelings for so long. Then I had kids. Music changed to Rubber Ducky.
Apostrophe E-E-O.
Come on, Black people, you know Z? E-E-O. dash J, 8H, and the H is silent. You got a friend named Max, and there's like 8 letters in his name. Too much. We just went with Zoe. Too tired for that. My sister calls me up, and she's like, Lisa, now that you're black, I got some questions for you. And I'm like, oh, yeah, for sure. She said, okay. She calls me back a week later and she's really mad. And I'm like, what's the matter, sweetheart? She said, well, I was at IKEA. And I'm like, well, that's a problem. I didn't know, tell you that you could shop at IKEA. I don't even know that black people shop at IKEA. I think it's Vanmart. I'm not sure. I said, what happened? She says, I was at the checkout and the manager was over there and made me mad. Wouldn't let me return something, and so I just yelled, and I said, somebody better get another manager. This place is off the hook! She said, Lisa, I didn't even realize I was saying it wrong until the lady 2 check stands over just shakes her head. She wasn't even black. I'm not giving any more black advice. Black enough. Black enough. Man, it is fun, though, raising boys and girls together. My boys are like, they're just like boys. They just like to play. They don't want to really answer questions with any more than one word that takes them away from playing. My daughter, though, she's like an information giver. She's like a tell-all. She's a tattletale, you guys. That's what I'm trying to say. She's a tattletale, my daughter. She's a tattletale. The day I put my kids to bed, and I said, look, I don't want to hear nothing out of you. Nothing. Gave him like my mean light. Yeah, that giggle, that's what I got. So I closed the door, I turned off the light, and I walked out of the room. A couple minutes later, I heard goings on coming from the bedroom. Goings on. So I went back down, I turned off, I opened the door, the light was off, and the kids were in bed. But I knew what I heard. So I turned on the light, and I said, real calm, everybody get up! I said, boys, did you get out of your bed and turn that light on? And the boys are like, nope. I said, Zoe, did you get out of your bed and turn that light on? And Zoe said, no. But then they got out of his bed, he jumped into Elijah's bed, then they ran around the bed, they tried to get in my bed. I said, don't you get in my bed, they heard you coming, they turned up the light, they got back in their bed. I didn't even know what to say. I'm pretty sure I heard one of the boys say to Zoe, snitches get stitches. Yeah, they pick that kind of stuff up when they're at home alone with their dad. I walked in the house one time and I heard the kids chanting, Jerry, Jerry, Jerry. Zoe looks over at my husband and says, you are not the father. Otherwise, he can pay that mortgage. My daughter comes up to me and she says, Mama, there's this boat. I want to go on this boat. And I said, all right, you want to go on a boat? Mama will take you on the boat. You tell me what that boat's called. Mama will take you on that boat. And she's like, I don't know what the name of the boat is, but Frozen's on that boat, and the trolls are on that boat, and Mickey Mouse is on that boat. I'm like, you know what? You tell me what the name of that boat is. Mama will take you on that boat. She comes back a couple days later and she's like, I know the name of the boat. Disney Cruise! And I was like, ow. All I could hear was ching, 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 ching. I said, Zoe, Mama can't take you on that boat. She said, why? I said, I don't have money for that boat. She said, well, you know what you could do? You could just keep working. And then she says, and I will just keep losing my teeth and save my tooth fairy. I'm like, oh, Zoe. You know what? On your 21st toothless birthday, I will take you. Too much, man. Little information giver, that one there. I drop my kids off at school, and an older kid comes up and he's like, hey, Jerome? Anything else about Jerome? No? Okay, well, let's move on to the walking Wikipedia. I said, Zoe, tell me about Jerome. So I was like, oh, Jerome. Yeah, he's in the third grade, but he's supposed to be in the fourth grade. We're not supposed to talk about it. He's named after his favorite uncle. They think it was the uncle that was in love with his mother. I'm like, whoa, Zoe. Slow down. WikiLeaks, just... happens, kind of take your kids to places that you otherwise wouldn't want to. When you have kids like the zoo, I don't like the zoo. I don't like the zoo because you have to walk at the zoo. I don't like the zoo. The animals are from like South America and North America and Africa, whatever, you know, and I just feels like you've walked there by the time you've gotten to the enclosure. I don't like it. But there's a baby jaguar, and I wanted to take my kids to see the baby jaguar, you know, to kind of make up for the whole Disney cruise thing. And so we get to the enclosure, and I see the mama jaguar pacing, but I don't see the baby. So I said, hey, zookeeper lady, I just trekked my kids 10 days to get to the enclosure. I'm just wondering where the baby jaguar is, because I see the mom, but, you know, I don't see the baby. And she said, oh, we had to take the baby to give him on the break. And I was like, oh, wow, why does she look so mad at that? Because if you were to take my kids to give me a break, I'd be like, hey, see you Wednesday. Maybe Thursday. So I didn't really know what to say. I just looked down at my kids and I said, kids, we're not gonna get to see the baby jaguar today. Because the baby jaguar is broken. That's my